Hey guys, are you at the point in your life where you're okay with your regular 9-to-5 job and you're considering a side hustle to bring in some extra money, but you really don't want to quit your job? Maybe you like your job and you like the security at your job and the perks of your job, like health insurance, and you simply want to keep it. Well, this video is for you. If you already have a side hustle, let me know in the comments below what that side hustle is and how do you like it. And if you don't have a side hustle, let me know in the comments below what you've been thinking about doing to earn some extra income. The key to this entire video is the fact that you don't have to quit your 9-to-5 job in order to make a ton of money on the side with a side hustle, especially with these 5 side hustles that I'm going to give to you on this video. Okay, let's go ahead and jump into these 5 side hustles for anyone over the age of 40 who wants to keep their 9-to-5. Okay, number 1 is start a YouTube channel. And I know that many of you will say, well, that's not really for me. I don't want to be in front of the camera. Guys, I can fully relate to that. Because me, I'm a voiceover guy. I'm used to being behind the scenes. And I never thought I'd be comfortable in front of a camera. But here I am. And you can do it too. Everything, including YouTube, is going to be hard at first. But it gets better. Is there something that you want to share with the world? Do you have an expertise in a particular area? Do you simply have something you love or enjoy doing? Or hey, are you just a funny and interesting person? If that's you, you can start a YouTube channel about whatever. The topic really doesn't matter because somebody is looking for every topic that you can imagine. Already, there's people that are searching for information about every topic in the world. And trust me, there's somebody somewhere in some corner of YouTube making really good money from YouTube doing exactly what you could be doing right now. Listen, YouTube is the second largest search engine in the world, and it's owned by the largest search engine in the world, Google. So right there, guys, is your community amongst billions and billions of people that use YouTube and Google every single day. Your target audience is out there somewhere waiting on you to make and upload your very first video. A year ago today, guys, I had about 1,500 subscribers on YouTube. Today, I have over 90,000 subscribers on YouTube. If I can do it, you can do it. And you can do it keeping your 9-to-5. All of the work you do on YouTube can be done before or after your regular 9-to-5 job. And don't worry about fancy equipment. Use your own phone. Look into some editing software or don't edit. Just go ahead and punch fear in the face and hit the record button. Now, let me backtrack just a moment because I want to explain to you why I named this video or titled this video the title. Yes, I'm talking about 5 side hustles, and really anybody can do these 5 side hustles. But I wanted to specifically target the person that's over 40 years old. Guys, sometimes as we get older and older, we sort of get comfortable and sort of stuck in our 9-to-5 jobs and our careers. So I wanted to make this video specifically letting people know that even though you're a little older and you may like your job or enjoy your career, it doesn't mean that you can't participate in earning a little additional income with a side hustle, and that you can do that and still work your 9-to-5 without overexhausting yourself or without stressing yourself out or maxing out your energy. So this video is applicable to anyone, but I wanted to speak specifically to that person who's in their late 30s, their early 40s, maybe into their 50s or 60s, to say, listen, just because you're over 40 doesn't mean you're too over the hill to do some of this additional income stuff too. Sometimes that older person, they need a little extra boost. They need a little extra encouragement and inspiration to actually do something. And that's what I wanted to do for you on this video, because it's usually that 40-year-old that is stuck between the traditional find a good job and earn a good living and the make money online crowd, right? That 40-year-old, 35, 40, 45, 50-year-old is usually right in the middle. We've been taught all our lives to find a good job and keep that good job. But now we see the new culture that's coming in that says you can make some extra additional money by working from home, working online, right? So this video says you can do both. Guys, if you get value from this video, please smash the like button below. And please consider subscribing to this channel if you're not already a subscriber. And also, don't forget to share this video with your friends and your family. Now, let's go to number 2. Number 2 is monetizing whatever skill, talent, or gift you have. You can coach, you can teach, you can consult other people, offer what you do or what you know as a service, and then you can use a platform like Sellify, Udemy, Teachable, Fiverr to actually market and sell and collect payments for what you do. You can sell coaching and mentoring in any area or teach your skills to other people. Some people have asked me, hey, well, how do I figure out what my talent or what my gift really is that I can sell to other people? Well, here's a few ideas to figure out what you have that you can monetize. First, poll or ask the people who know you the best. How do you make them feel when you're around them? What's the first thing they think about when they think of you? Just ask the people that know you and let them tell you and be as honest as possible with you. That may be a key to what gift you have that's naturally inside of you. Or what makes you angry? Maybe the thing that makes you angry is the thing that you're supposed to fix. Or what is the thing that you do better than most people without a whole lot of effort? Think back in your life. What was your favorite job? And why was it your favorite job? That could be the key to what your true gift is, your true natural God-given talent. And what is your skill? What is your skill set that you've acquired over the years? Right? Oftentimes we have a job, but throughout the course of working that job, we often fall into our natural talents and abilities and skills. Now, I'm not a passion guy. I'm a purpose guy. Passion is good. I like passion. Passions are for you to enjoy. But I believe that your purpose is in your gift and your talents, and that purpose is for other people. So your passion is for you. Your purpose on this planet is for others. And sometimes your passion is your purpose. But oftentimes your passion and your purpose could very well be two different things. But when you find that gift, I think you're gonna find your purpose. Now, once you identify your gift, your talent, your purpose, your natural God-given skills, then practice it, perfect it, get better at it, and then ultimately monetize it. And you can monetize it through some of the platforms that I mentioned earlier, right? The Teachable, the Fiverr, those types of platforms. And that way, other people can be blessed by your gift, by your talent, by your set of skills. Guys, for 2 years on this channel, I gave away free 15 to 20 minute phone calls to anyone who wanted to sit down and have a conversation about their money. And over the course of that 2 years, I got better and better and better at listening to people, at answering questions, at helping people come to the conclusions of what they want and reach their goals financially. I have a gift and I have a purpose. And with that gift and purpose, I gave it away for free while I perfected it. And now I monetize it. I offer one-on-one financial mentoring and coaching through the website, the platform called Teachable. I'll put a link to that below in the description box. But listen, you can do the exact same thing with your gift. Now, the third side hustle for anyone over 40 who wants to keep their 9-to-5 job is selling digital products. Now, what is a digital product? Digital products are intangible goods that exist in digital form. Now, here's a bunch of examples of what digital products are. Cheat sheets, recipes, top 10 list, instructions of any kind, guides or guidebooks, ebooks, apps, themes, plugins, graphic art, digital art, online courses, lifestyle tips, right? Digital planners, newsletters, wallpaper that you can sell for the screensaver on your phone or screensavers on a laptop or computer, posters, emojis, PowerPoint presentations, clip art, exercise routines, sound effects, beats if you're a musical person, stock photos, anything that you can PDF or send electronically is a digital product. Now, where can you sell digital products? You can sell digital products on your own website, on your own landing page, or a website, again, like Fiverr or Teachable, ConvertKit, WooCommerce, etc. There's tons of places where you can actually sell and market your digital products. Now, I'm gonna leave links to some of those in the description box below as well. If you click on those links, I get a little bit of something-something for recommending that to you, but that's no additional cost to you. But those are great places where you can actually sell these digital products that you create. And how do you create them? You can create them anywhere. Canva is a great place to create digital products, or Microsoft Publisher, or audio stuff on Audacity or Adobe, right? There's a lot of different places where you can create these digital products. And once you create them, again, you have to market them, guys. You have to get the word out. You have to create a buzz about them, or at least let people know what you sell. The beauty about digital products is you create them one time. And after you create them and spend a lot of time and effort creating them, you can sell an unlimited amount of them because it doesn't take any work to ship them. For example, you have a PDF, you can sell 10,000 PDFs in the next hour for $5 a piece. And you don't have to lift a finger, you don't have to ship anything out, you just sell it online. And that makes digital products a great way to earn additional income. Now, number four is selling on Amazon or eBay or any platform where you can buy things low and sell things high. Amazon and eBay are just two ways that are fantastic ways to do it that have been around for a while. But you can sell on any platform, Shopify, Craigslist, Facebook Marketplace, right? It doesn't matter. You're just buying things low, selling things high. And I mentioned eBay because I used eBay for many years to sell products on. And eBay today is still the second leading online marketplace here in America, behind Amazon. But if you plan to sell on Amazon or eBay or any other place, be sure to do your research and start with a few things that are simply around your house to get you going so you can learn and understand the platform before increasing your inventory that you plan to sell. And you can also look into drop shipping as well. Now, the fifth side hustle for anyone that's over 40 that also wants to keep their 9-to-5 is simply renting or leasing something of value that you own or that you possess. It could be space in your home, it could be equipment, it could be a car, etc. Websites like Turo and RentWorks where you can lease your car, or websites like Airbnb or VRBO, where you can rent out an actual physical place for people. You can obviously also rent out space in your own home if you have a spare bedroom or a basement. As times are getting tougher and tougher, guys, we're seeing that rents have increased, and these types of more alternative living situations are becoming more and more popular. So why not get paid from renting a room or a space in your house or a basement? Or maybe you have some equipment that you can rent out. Tools, power machines, stoves, whatever it could be. Something that you could rent out to other people. I have a friend who used to rent out what we called a cherry picker, right? That's the big old piece of equipment that pulls engines from cars. And it takes those engines and puts them back in place to put back in cars, right? We called it a cherry picker. But he used to rent that out for other people to use. And it ultimately paid for itself in a matter of a couple of months. But if you have something that other people want or value, consider renting it out. Could be something like an RV, a camper, a drone, photo booths, boat, costumes, strollers, high chairs, tables and folding tables and tablecloths for events, lawnmowers, arcade games for parties, wedding gowns. I mean, you name it. If other people want it and desire it, you can rent it out and make money at it. Just do your research. Hey guys, be sure that with any of these side hustles, you always read the fine print. Check your laws, your rules, your regulations that govern the city, the state, the county, or the country that you're in before you attempt to go full bore on any of these. And also, taxes. Be sure you have or you hire a really good solid CPA who can help you properly report the income from these side hustles so you can pay taxes. And please be sure you pay the right amount of taxes. Take it from a person like me. I've been audited by the IRS before. You want to make sure you keep really, really good records. And after that, go for it. Have fun learning something new. Enjoy the process, be consistent and relentless, and remember, you can do it. And you can do it while keeping your 9-to-5. If you need help, please consider joining this channel. On this channel, if you join at the advanced level, I offer 15-minute one-on-one calls with me on a monthly basis to help you. I really hope you got something of value out of this video. Please smash the like button below, share this video with your friends and your family and your network of good people, and please consider subscribing to my channel. Hey, the best person who's gonna take care of the old you is the young you. Do me a favor, take good care of yourself, and take care of other people. Until the next video, peace.